Hello guys, Gepish Amino here, and in this video I'm going to show you guys the new lake. So it's a little bit a let's play the new lake in Fishing Planet Alaska. It's going to take some time. It's a little bit different what I do normally. I just say to you guys, you throw there, we do this. Now I'm going blindly to the lake. I never been there. I'm just preparing my setup, and yeah, we are just going to check out a little bit how it works. I'm not sure that I can do this stuff really well because I'm a guide maker, but let's have a try and let's have a look how it goes. So yeah, first of all, I'm getting the River Tex Zois, so it's 21 kilograms. So we are going with power, guys. It's going to be a spinning setup. I'm going to get a spinning setup. I'm going to fuck the casting setup because spinning is now for the cool kids. So if you check it out, 21 kilograms. So I'm still really excited. Let's get the spinning rod, the heaviest that we can have. And then we are going to put on the 0.6 millimeter fluoro. So yeah, we are going after the big fish. It's like river monsters at the moment in this video. Okay, so let's get the reels, the spinning reels. What is the heaviest one? 19 kilograms. Yes, this is my best friend now. The retrieve is just as recovery is very high. I like high recoveries. So let's buy this one. Let's go now for the fluoro insane line. Is it 18.1? Yes, it's 18. Let's go with 1000 meter right away. If you do something, you always need to think big. That's my philosophy in life. So let's buy this one. And now it's time. Let's get some spinners. Let's get the spinners, the new spinners, and let's get the other new stuff. The what is it? The single spoon. Yeah, that's what we are going to get. So, and let's go right away with the gold ones. If there are gold ones, I don't think there are gold ones. So, yeah, what this one looks really cool, but I'm going with the heaviest one. So let's get a 36 one. Yeah, and let's get a 24 one. That's okay. Let's get a single spoon. That's the new stuff too. A single spoon. The 21 here. Yeah, he looks cool enough. And oh, there is a 42 G2. Okay, you're my spoon. 42 G. Okay, that's good. So I need to make a little bit of space now in my inventory, and there we are off, guys. So yeah, it's a little bit laggy at the moment, so I think a lot of players are logging in. I can understand that. So the new reel, and I probably first need to get one out of my box because otherwise it's going to say that I got too much equipment. So yeah, my lucky charm rock can go. Let's make a little bit of room. I got so much scrap, it's unbelievable. Yeah, this grub, I probably don't need it. The tubes, it's too small. I'm expecting river monsters in Alberta, the 5 crow can go to. I'm just making a little bit room for the new spinners and for the single spoon at the moment. So, yeah, do I need this? 4-0, bar plus jigget, there you go. That's for small fish. We are not going for small fish. Do I got double crankbaits here? No, the best jigs, yeah, let's keep them here too. Because I don't think that the best jig is going to be very good at the new lake. Because there is no bass. It's possible there is bass, but I don't think so. I got a medium spoon, that's good for the trout there. I got the crankbaits are good too. I hope that the new spinner can equip any more items. Okay, 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 game. Let's go to the spinners. Spinners. Okay, let's have a look. Single spoon. Here it is. Okay, this comes with me. And this comes with me. Okay, that are the new, the two new spinners. And now here the bullet spinner. I like the bullet spinner, to be honest. It looks cool. It's, yeah. Okay. So that's okay. So now we need to make a little bit of room for my line. And that's always a little bit a tough fight with the game, making room. Because you always cut in this game your line, and you keep cutting and you keep cutting the whole time. And yeah, that's problematic because now I deleted something, and that doesn't mean that I can get now the 0.6 fluorine. That's the main problem. So I hope that I already can equip it. And I'm just going to close all this stuff because if I need to scroll every time that I do this stuff. Okay, fingers crossed. Yeah, it doesn't work. We need to delete some more. Okay, let's get this. 0.2. Oh, yeah, this is... Yeah, I'm going to sell this too because it's wear out. This one can go too. Okay, fingers crossed again, guys. That's the problem. You really don't know how much space that you still got for line. Yeah, now it's okay. So I deleted four of them, but I'm not sure how that worked, that system. So here we go. Rail must be equipped. Yeah, fucking noob. Unbelievable. okay, I need to get the new reel too. So let's scroll up. Reels. Ah, here it is. The River Dex. Okay, this one. Then we get... come on, game. Then we got new line. This one. And then we are going to put... Let's... only 92. Ah, fuck. That's a pity. 92 meters. So the cast is not going that far. So maybe the 0.6 is not really for the spinning rods. Because you see 92 meters only, but maybe we can adjust a little bit with like the bread line. Let's try to... Do we got an off with up? Yeah, we got mono 0.5 with us too. How much? Zero mono? Mono is a little bit further, but let's check it out. Maybe the weight of the lure is very high. So 36, I think, and 48. So yeah, 36. So it's possible. Okay. Good setup, guys. Yeah, before I forgot, the most important. I don't have the new net. I almost forgot this stuff. So let's go to equipment. Here it is. Yeah, let's buy this beast. 4K. Bang in the pocket, man. In the pocket. Okay, let's equip it. Let's go down. We need to go to my home depot. I got so much equipment. I can understand that people that start this game get sometimes dizzy. You see all that equipment. And I think that the game is lagging again. Come on, game. Keep it up. Keep it up, buddy. Come on. Yeah, check. It's not loading my new net. Come on. Ah, okay. Oh. Ah, it's just a glitch. Check. You got now, space. That is where you don't get like your equipment. Okay, the new 300 kilograms. Okay, let's put it here. Okay, guys, we are ready. 8 minutes of getting this stuff ready. But it's now time to go to Alaska. And let's buy the license. Let's hope that we can get some good fish in. And there is even we got like a percentage down of the maximum price. Because normally it's 300 for one day. So yeah, it's a lot of money. Let's hope. And I got still two red fish that I cannot take. So it's possible that I need to take the other license too. But yeah, we will see how it goes. I'm going to drink a little bit because it's now... Oh, check this. Nice, 3 packs. So, yeah, it looks cool. It looks a little bit different than the other graphical area. So, what do we got? Angling the Middle Earth. What the hell? Is it Frodo Baggins that we are going to find here? Taming the Canique. And now it's still with the Q, so that's okay. Hunter's Cabin. So let's go to Hunter's Cabin. That's a picture I already saw in the pictures that we got before this lake came live. So, yeah, okay. Here is, and now we can run around. Yeah, check these guys. Yeah, and it's totally full with people. I was exp Oh, you can. Oh, sh oh, what the hell? I'm Jesus. I can run on the water. Oh, this looks cool. So, it's really a river. Can I run here too? No, this is the end. What the hell? This looks cool. Okay, let's go to the new spinning rod. Yeah, check this out. Oh, this looks cool. And let's go a little bit further in the time. So, yeah, it looks really cool. And I'm going to put a little bit my sound higher because at the moment, yeah, check this place. It's so quiet here and so lovely. It looks cool. I can, as a person, I can live in that cabin over there without any people and all that stuff. So, okay, let's do a throw. Let's have a look what we can get here. Check. 59 meters. So what I said about the amount of lime doesn't matter. You can throw really far with this setup. So it doesn't matter. I was a little bit worried that the cast was going to be too not far enough, but that's not true. 59 meters is more than enough. Let's have a look that we can get the fish here now. Yeah, I'm fishing totally blind at the moment, guys. First time here. And I'm not seeing a lot of people getting fish in the chat, so that means that it's not difficult for that reason, but maybe the people are just starting here. And the main problem is that it's very hard to detect because now you are playing with the salmon. Salmon, they are not sitting on okay, they like holes and rock formations, but for a bass or a pike it's easy. If you see weeds, if you see green stuff in the water, you can say, okay, fuck it, I'm going out to throw over there. I'm getting a pike, I'm getting my bass, my bowfin. But for a salmon, it's another story. For the trout, just the same. So it can be somewhere, it can be a hole. But you need to find it, of course. But I see already a rock formation over there. So I think if I want to make a chance, I think I need to go over there. If I can run over there. But this is really cool. If you are getting too hot, you can check the water. You can just stand here and it looks really cool. That was always so good in this game that it looks always great. And here I can run. Yeah, I need to check that there are no bears here because with all that fish that I'm catching at the moment, so you need to watch it a little bit. So this looks a really cool spot for salmon, I think. There is a log that I see right away, another log. That's probably going to be the pike area. So I think if I can throw over there my spinner, it's probably I'm going to get a chance to get a pike. I'm not sure what the pike is, but I will know when I get it. Because it's not called the pike in his name. It has to be something else. Let's have a look what we can get here. Yeah, and I'm just going with the simple stop and go 3-speed. That's always the easiest one. It's possible that because now I'm fishing a little bit different than I do most of the time if I go to new lakes. For the guys that don't know, I'm going to put a little bit tutorial in it. I cannot stop with it, you know. So the thing is that I always start with the lowest weight, lowest spinner, because if you can locate the small fish, most of the time you are going to get the big fish too. And you don't need to have like a specific lure anymore to get a fish. At the moment, everything bites on everything almost. You can throw everything to the fish. So yeah, let's do a throw. And it's a long lake, this one. What the hell? You can run all the way. This looks so great. I'm wondering that I can stand on the other side of this lake. Let's do another throw here between the rocks. Maybe I can find the salmon. Okay, here we go. Because at the moment I'm fishing with a very heavy setup, a 6-0 hook. So it's possible that maybe I'm going to the, what is the other one, 24 that I got in the bullet spinner. Because I think this is purely, yeah, it can be, I know it can be salmon too, spinners. Yeah, and this place is totally dead, guys. Guys, I'm going to rage, you know? That's forecast and I don't have a fish. No, I'm just joking. But it's the same in the chat. There are a lot, not a lot of people getting fish at the moment. So it's not going to be easy to identify all the fish here. But yeah, we will figure it out at some point. So. Come on, fishy. No, they don't want to come. Yeah, the main problem is I don't have a sight what is the weight of the fish. So you don't know that. Let's have a look here. This is a nice log. I guess it's pike, but pike most of the time don't like spinners. But it's a possibility that we get the pike over there. So it's really shallow there. Okay. Yeah, check how shallow it is. It's my spinner is almost jumping out of the water. Yeah, it's northern pike that is sitting here. Ah, okay. But I don't want northern pike. I want salmon. So the pike that sits here is the northern pike. So it's not one of the new fish. So that's good. Okay, guys, let's go to the other pech, but let's try to run around. Oh fuck, I cannot run through the woods here, I guess. Can I go back? I think if I try a little bit more here, I think I'm going to get some salmon here or maybe trout. But I want to check the other pechs out too, that you guys can check it out, other pechs. But this looks really cool, and you see the water is moving now too, so it's really a river. I'm going to test something else, so. With my bobber. I'm going to check that my bobber is floating away. Because now it needs to go really fast if this is a river. Ah, there, trophy Chinook salmon. With my buddy Darren. Haha, that is the first one. That's the first trophy. So that's not bad. That's not bad. Okay, let's have a look. So we are now here, Hunter's cabin. Let's go now angling the Middle Earth and let's have a look over there. Oh, it looks all the same. But it looks cool. It's like I like rivers. When I was really young, that was the coolest thing that I liked about fishing. Fly fishing in like yeah, in rivers. And then standing in the water and all that stuff. Ah, he went with the spinner blue, so he's just using the same stuff what I'm using at the moment. Oh, check! Jumping fish! What the fuck? So they got the jump. Did you guys see that? What the hell? So, but here is a fish. Here is a fish sitting in the water. But it's still the jumping fish is still in the game, guys. It came to Alaska too, but there is a fish. There is a fish, that's good. And he was a little bit red. I saw red with white. So now, oh, there is a jumping fish again. What the hell? So let's hope that I can get a bite. So there on the rock, in the middle of the water here. But he wasn't that big. So it's a possibility that my spinner is a little bit too heavy for this dude. But that's already two times that I got a jumping fish, and jumping fish, that means that there is fish. That's always good. So we got now a chance that I'm getting a fish in. Is it a Chinook? It looks, I think it was a salmon. I'm not sure. Let's have a look again. That we got a jumping fish again. Come on, fishy. No, diminishing hotspots. It's done. That zone. Yeah, no bite. Yeah, it's cool. The lake looks really cool with the mountains on the background and all that stuff. So check this. I'm totally alone here. Only some crazy people that are sitting here in the woods, but besides that, I'm totally alone in this place. But I want to catch a fish, to be honest. Come on, fishy. There are already guys in the chat. What's the best way to catch salmon? Like, yeah, this is live for 1 hour, I think. Yeah, you know, get the spreadsheet, guys. Check out the time frames. It's all already available. You need to throw over there. It's it's funny, but yeah, that guy, maybe he doesn't know it, but I think it's funny. So like everybody got already a suitable plan to get all the fish in this lake. It's going to take some time, I think, because it's a very big lake. You got a lot of constructions that I see. You got rock formations, you got logs, and I think that the fish stopped biting, and that's not so good. So you know what I'm going to do after this recast, not recast, retrieve, sorry. I'm going to change my lure. I think it's a little bit too big. Because if I see Northern Pike 2.5, so and the trophy Chinook was only 10 kilograms. So it's a possibility that I'm fishing with the equipment for the uniques and the very big trophies here. So yeah, sorry, drinking for a moment because if you need to talk a lot like I'm doing now at the moment, yeah, you need to drink a lot. Okay, let's have a look what we got over there. Now I went to the 24G30, that's a little bit less big. But I got the impression that you don't need to throw that far, and that's very good. So this is for me, this is real fishing, you know. Standing on the shore, trying to find the construction. You don't need to throw 70 meters to get a fish and all that stuff. You are in nature. That's a big part of fishing for me too, being in nature. So yeah, and that fish, I got right away a bite at the start, but now it seems that it's really dead over there. And I don't see a lot of people getting fish in the chat. So maybe they still need to activate the fish here. Yeah. I told you guys. Lower the stuff. Yeah, check this first fish incoming. Oh, I think it's a Chinook. What the hell is this? Check this. It's a trophy chum salmon. A right away trophy, guys. So yeah, okay. So it was indeed a salmon that I was seeing, but it seems that I needed to lower my that I need to lower my lure weight. My lure, yeah, it was a little bit too big. The hook, I think. Let's try to get another one. A right away trophy time. So for the guys, partly cloudy, 7 to 8 a.m. trophy time for this salmon. So no, I'm just joking, guys. I think it's probably the spinner that always gives a trophy. Let's try to get another one, and then we can check a little bit the experience and the currency on this dude. Oh, here we go. Yeah. Now we are doing this stuff, guys. Yeah, I'm at the moment already practicing a little bit for the tournament, and that's the next one. Is it a trophy again? No, this is a chum salmon. And on first sight, I can be wrong, but on first sight, is the experience high? Is 8 kilo for 8 kilograms fish? Yeah, it's high, I think. I don't know at the moment. Is it so? That means let's do a quick calculation. So let's see, 5 kilograms is 200 experience. So 5 kilograms, that's in a net of 100 kilograms multiplied 20. So that's 4,000 experience if you get a 100 kilogram net full with this fish. And I think that's good. I think the experience is good. So that means if you got premium, if you get those fish, you got 6 to 8K premium. And probably the trophy gives a little bit more compared to the wait. No, the trophy. I was expecting 300-400 here, but the currency is a lot higher. So, yeah, on first sight, I can be wrong, but it doesn't seem that bad. Because this area is probably going to be level 22, maybe 23, because you can use equipment here that is level 23. But I think we identified already this spot. So here is the chum salmon. Let's do one more try, because I had two in a row. Let's make it three in a row if it is possible. But you can get it all over the way. So yeah, I just threw here because I got rock formation on the other side. Therefore, I did it. But this works really well. Let's explore a little bit more, guys. It looks a little bit like No Man's Skies. But then, yeah, 10 times better. You can do more things in this area than I could do in No Man's Skies in like 30 hours of playing. Okay, check this. Ah, it's so cool. And I don't hear like birds that are driving me crazy at the moment. So I think. Oh, check this. This is like so pike position, or maybe a hole for the trout. So let's do a throw over here. And let's have a look. And I think before work, I think that I can just make a quick video too how you need to catch the shum salmon or chum. So that's what I'm going to do. If I can still remember it. Let's have a look that we can. But I know that in California, the salmon was known for his currency and not for experience. And here it's a little bit the same, I think. You get a nice amount of currency for it. The trophy was almost 80 currency. Is that a lot? No, that's not really a lot. Multiplied 12, that's only 720 currency for 100 kilogram. But yeah, we need to wait and check it out. And I don't see jumping fish, so I'm not sure there is sitting a fish. So let's just throw in the middle of the lake here. But I'm very happy. It looks really cool, guys. There is so much. Finally, we got new content. You guys know that I'm a guy of content. If it depends on me, I always think every 2 3 months, give us new content, give us like 50 species in each area, give us uniques of every fish. It's okay, it's not real life, I know that, but it's fun, you know. So I always like new stuff, and I think a lot of people like the new stuff. So yeah, but I don't see jumping fish here, so I don't think that I'm going to get a fish here. But trophy Shosho Salmon. My buddy Roche got one. Okay, I don't see a lot of activity here. That's two casts. It can be the spinner too, but the spinner, I think that five, we got eight species here that I know, nine now, because Northern Pike, I see him in the chat too. So that means salmon likes the spinner. We can already say that. I'm 100% sure that the trout likes it too. And I always need to check it that you cannot run here through the water, because I'm not sure that we go to the other side of this, what is it, the river here. But there are so many here, maybe? No, it's still too deep. And I'm not sure that I can go. I probably need to teleport. Whoa, check this. Is this yeah, let's throw over here and let's have a look. Because most of the time the sweet stuff is sitting outside the area that you need to fish. So let's have a look that we can get something. It's very shallow there. So we are not going to find trout there. Maybe salmon. That's a possibility. But yeah, salmon, it seems you can find it everywhere here. But there is the pink salmon. So there is a guy. So a normal pink salmon is 2 kilograms. So that's probably the smallest of the salmon. So he's not going to go higher than what is it, 5 kilogram trophy wise. So that's a small one. Yep, no action at all, not even a small bite. So that means, yeah, sometimes you got like small bites, and that means that your lure equipment is too big for that fish. But you already know, yeah, there is some activity going on. So, but now, no, I don't see any action. Okay, let's go to the other pech. On the other side, I think, or is this the same? Is this the. Oh no! We are now in the middle. Ah, okay, I was just standing over here, I think. Damn, I'm so confused now. What the hell? Yeah, I. Huh? Was I now just throwing over here from this lock? But I know it's now in the middle. Can we see some fish here hatching? So let's go all the way to over there and just check it out. Yeah, you can keep running. I hope that we can get to the. Oh, this is a good place. I see some. Yeah, probably here can be trout. It's a little bit same like Colorado. Big rock formation. Most of the time that means that you got like a hole near it. But you never know, and it's very shallow here. You guys see it on my lure. It goes very high outside of the water almost. So let's have a look. Let's have a look how it goes. Oh, yeah. I think that it's better, I think, if I go here with the crankbait. A 1 meter crankbait. Just to retrieve. But yeah, I want to go with the bullet spinner. That's no equipment, so no equipment is always cool. And how far can I go? No. So I just am I limited on this? No, I can. Is it possible that I go all the way to the other side? I don't think so. I'm not sure, but I don't think so. Ah, yeah, we can. Okay, cool. So now I'm on the other side of the river. Let's go all the way to here. Oh, there is. Ah, cool. There is a guy, the first guy that got a unique pink salmon. So the first unique, I'm not sure that it's the first unique because there are a lot of other servers with other languages, but that's the first one. So the unique pink salmon is 5 kilograms. So it's a little bit the same like in Alberta when we were fishing there. That was like 5 seconds, and there was a guy that got a unique northern pike. So that's not bad fishing. But I guess that at the moment for the uniques, you just need to fish in like the best time of the day. That was in the past a little bit different. You always needed to fish outside the best time in the day. But now at the moment, they are. Yeah, now the guy's asking, what pech are you? So I'm going to check a little bit what he's saying. And maybe in this video, I can show you guys the pink salmon too. Yeah, and it's so shallow here. It's unbelievable. I'm wondering that that my equipment is not too heavy for this stuff. Ah, he's fishing over here because I think that I'm in the upper river point because the water is going to the left. Yeah, he's sitting here on the Iceland, the island, sorry, that I'm sitting on too. So let's have a look that we can get like the pink salmon too. Yeah, too shallow. Too shallow for my bullet spinner. Okay. Let's but the area is very big that we can catch fish here. Oh, I can now. I can throw. Yeah, I stand now in the water and I can throw in front of me. This is cool. This is cool stuff. Ah, this is cool. So we can fish now from out of. Oh, check that! Check! A fish! Is this the pink? Yeah, pink salmon. Oh, this is cool. I was thinking, yeah, I was just running through the water and I was thinking, like, oh, I can stand in the water and I can cast in the water. So, yeah, let's do this stuff. They look so silly, this salmon. Did you guys see that? So it's going to be probably my sex, my oh sex, what the fuck, my second video. How to catch the pink salmon here. Let's have a look that we can get another one. Because it's cool, all those salmons, they are jumping. So if they bite, they jump for a brief moment out of the water. Because I think it's not that deep here, therefore we can see them. But it's really cool. So this is real fishing, you know. I'm sure if I throw a large minnow at them or a shiner, I think hook 2-0, 3-0 that I'm going to catch them too. And probably I think that the guy that got unique in the chat here, he caught that fish over here too, I think. So we got now the chump salmon, we got the pink salmon. So that's six fish that we still need to go. I'm going to check the graphic too for this day because at the moment I'm just freelancing, but there are always some points that you need to check. Oh, check. Another one. Oh, they make. Yeah, it's really cool. And another pink one. Okay, let's have a look. Let's have a look to the time frame. Ah, okay, I'm now until noon. Even until late in the afternoon, we are good. But let's explore a little bit more, guys. So, yeah, we are now running on the other shore. And here starts the river. Because the water is going over there. So, it's so small. You know what? I can almost catch the fish here with my hands. So, you can just run the whole way. Over here, let's have a look that we can get on the opposite side that I was getting the what was it, the shum salmon or the chubby salmon, what the hell, those names, and they look so strange, but it's such a big area, it's unbelievable. I want to do, if I'm done with work, I'm going to do this whole small river here, I'm going to do with my bobber. So just check it out. But you can, I think now a shift to a fast run is not so bad, I think, in this area. And I'm not sure that we can go further than this one. So this is all pink area, pink salmon area. But, you can go over here. And I'm now running. Oh, what the fuck was this? This was a sneaky pet. No, it was just a dead end. Yeah, and it seems, I'm not sure, but I don't think that I was fishing here on the rock formation. I'm not sure that I can get. Can I? No. I think the rock formation is here behind the trees. So, you cannot fish over there. Oh, yeah, you can. So, I think it was here. That was the rock formation. So, if I throw here, I'm going to get that salmon again. Let's have a look. That it's right what I'm saying at the moment. No bite. Let's explore a little bit more for the end of the video because it's already 14 minutes. So yeah, it was something else what I do usually, but it is cool to explore new stuff. And this area is so big, and you got everywhere you got like small roads to the river. So there is so much to explore here. It's unbelievable. Check how far that I can run. There is the cabin, I think. In the, is that the cabin? It's so unbelievable big. But that's Alaska, I think. So Alaska is a very big place with a lot of nature, but check this out. Jesus Christ, you can run so far. Can I? Yeah, I can run over the water again. Yeah, check this. There is no end, guys. It keeps going and going and going. Oh, we are going to. It's going to take so much time this to discover everything, but that's cool. That's what I like. Check how far that I can run. It keeps going, and here it stops, I think. And probably, yeah, is this the end? Ah, here. Wait. Aha. So that means there is pike. Let's have a look. I think this is the deeper part of the river. Let's have a look that we can get something here. I'm going to do a couple of more casts, guys, and then I'm going to end the video. But yeah, my first impression is it looks really cool. There is a lot of fish that is sitting here already. It's salmon territory, but I think the most people were expecting that Alaska salmon. So, but it looks cool. There is going to be a lot of exploration going on in this area. We already got a unique pink salmon, so that's always good too. And there is a sockeye salmon. So I think that I saw all the salmons. I just need to check the sucker, but I guess sucker is probably the same like in Alberta and Colorado, just peace, maximum depth. And that's what it's going to be. Okay. The last cast for today. Let's hope that we can get this area smells a little bit for trout. It reminds me of a trout area. Like open water, somewhere is going to be a hole, and it's going to be a trout, I think. Because I didn't saw a guy getting the trout in the shed. So it's a possibility, but this is down on the river. So you got upper river, you got down river. I think that I'm now on the down river. So and it's getting very big here, the river, in size. It's very deep here too. You guys can see it on my spinner. Okay, that's it, guys. Okay, it's going to be the end of the video. I'm going to make two more videos before work because I'm running a little bit late on. I'm going to upload this video. Thanks for watching, guys. First sight, it looks really cool. I hope that you enjoy it. We got finally a spinning setup. It's going to be fun, I think, the next couple of weeks. If you like the video, give me a like. If you like my channel, subscribe. Have fun in Alaska, guys, and I see you guys the next time. Tight lines. Bye bye.